The World Cup of Hockey preliminary round, the U.S. taking on Europe in Toronto, Canada. Jonathan Quick, the starter in net for Team USA in the round-robin format, going up against Yaroslav Halak in goal for Europe. We go to the Air Canada Centre for the action.
Hit himself in the corner, but he made the play, got the puck out. Racing through the neutral zone, Franz Nielsen, Gavrik in front, scores! A two-on-one, and there's a couple of Europeans that do have speed. Marian Gavrik makes it 1-0 for Europe.
Franz Nielsen with a perfectly threaded pass, and Gavrik with his stick on the ice. What a start for Jonathan Quick. The first shot of the game is one cross-crease and right in the back of the net.
Just about every power play in this tournament. Matt Zuccarello, lone defender. There's Nielsen with a shot, and a nice save by Quick on Franz Nielsen. They were 2 or 3 days later than the other teams with their training camp. Here's a 2-on-1. Zuccarello, Nielsen, and he's stopped by Jonathan Quick. Another 2-on-1, and another one featuring this same line. And he's going to do a lap. MVP Patrick Kane closed off, and this is a 2-on-0 the other way. Leon Draisaitl in front, gets it back and scores. Just when it looked like Patrick Kane might get something for Team USA.
The Europeans chip and chase, and here's a nice little give and go. Look at the effort by Quick at the last second to try to get back.
There's the extra ice time for Kane we talked about. Kane with Kessler in front. Halak gets across, got a piece of it, and Kessler got a piece of him. And gets a hold of the puck. Ryan Suter into the middle, takes the shot, a deflection, Halak the save, the rebound into the net. But how did it get into the net?
I think this one will come back.
It's right off the chest of Van Riemsdyk, so it has to be a distinct motion of knocking it in. You be the judge. I don't know, Van Riemsdyk to me might have just kept his chest pumped out there. Any forward motion?
Upon video review, the puck is intentionally directed in the net off the body. This is an illegal goal, no goal.
Here's a chance out of the penalty box. Christian Ehrhoff trying to get a breakaway, and he gets hit against the puck, centering. Hansen to the net, a tip, they score. 3-0 lead for Team Europe. Pierre-Edward Bellemare, after a big U.S. power play failed. Europe gets the puck back. Josi again with a shot off the stick. Here's a chance for Thomas Vanek. His pass, McDonough intercepted, but then he couldn't control the puck. What a save by Quick there off Tatar.
Just make sure he gets his arm up, hit right in the crook of his elbow there, as that one had a chance as Tatar in alone.
And off the skater's pass, Oshie again with a slap shot. Halak on the rebound, stop! Abdelkader right in front of the net. Here's TJ Oshie. John Carlson fires a shot, Halak the save. There's a rebound, it's up for grabs, and Halak is down with lots of help.
Europe shuts down the U.S., taking it 3-0. Yaroslav Halak tallies 35 saves to pick up the shutout. Marian Gavrik got Europe up early in the first. Jonathan Quick with 14 stops for Team USA. Up next, the U.S. plays Team Canada on Tuesday. Europe is back in action against the Czech Republic on Monday. The World Cup of Hockey preliminary round, host country Canada taking on the Czech Republic in Toronto. Michael Neuwirth in net for the Czech Republic, and Carey Price getting the start for Team Canada. To the Air Canada Centre we go.
Andre Palat, he had a great pre-tournament and he has a great start here. Hansel to Palat, what a save by Price. Welcome back, Carey. Straight up the middle, Sidney Crosby in alone. Great save by Neuwirth, and what a first 50 seconds of this game.
Jay Bouwmeester gets caught to the outside. That leaves a chance at the net. A reaction save by Price, and then right back the other way. Sidney Crosby inside of Kempe. And Michael Neuwirth, you mentioned, Jim, his first real big test, and he passes it with flying color.
Crosby comes off the bench, centering pass, Marchand hit the side of the net, Crosby scores! Bank shot!
Remember, there is a coach's challenge here, but that one, the Neuwirth didn't see it, and I think you might get a challenge here by the Czech. Look at the stick between the legs there, Neuwirth, though, to me, wasn't in a position to react because he didn't see where the puck was.
Out there for the review, the ruling on the ice stands, we have a good goal.
Bergeron in to take this faceoff. His strong side against Hansel, and he wins the draw. Crosby to the blue line. Burns shoots, he scores!
but it's how quickly from the drop of the puck back to the point, no hesitation, a bit of a knuckler that did get deflected.
Turned the puck over, Marchand lost it in his feet, centering pass, Bergeron scores! He beat the buzzer!
An excellent pass, tape to tape, perfectly placed. Look at the vision of Neuvirth. He had no idea where that puck was, and I don't think there's any question that this one is going to count.
Here he is again in front on his backhand to Thornton. He scores!
Getting caught in their own zone, and Crosby jumps out at the remnants of that fourth line, and look at the turnover. Quick own pass to the slot, and everybody in the building knows where it's going.
Crosby, hard pass, Stamkos shoots, what a save by Neuvirth.
Neuvirth here down, can't find the puck, looking through traffic, hard cross seam pass, and just desperation.
And in comes Getzlaff, Taves to Getzlaff, in front they score! Jonathan Taves finished it off, Canada leads 5-0.
Good players just having some fun, trying anything, no-look pass, backhand pass, off of Taves and in the back of the net.
Doughty again, Petrangelo again, shoots, he scores!
Jonathan Taves, all his role here is just mirror where the puck is and make sure you're in the eyes of the goaltender. And clearly from that reaction, no chance whatsoever for Neuvirth to pick that up.
What an impressive start to the World Cup for Canada. Six-nothing over the Czech Republic.
Team Canada blanks the Czech Republic 6-0. Sidney Crosby picked up right where he left off after winning the Stanley Cup, notching a goal and two assists. Carey Price with the shutout, stopping 27 shots in his first competitive game action since injuring his knee on November 25th, playing for Montreal. Up next, Canada plays Team USA on Tuesday. The Czech Republic tries to rebound Monday against Team Europe.
Group A action Monday from the Air Canada Centre. Europe battling the Czech Republic. The Euros looking to build on a shutout victory over Team USA, while the Czechs seeking to bounce back from a 6-0 drubbing at the hands of Canada and avoid an 0-2 start.
The boards couldn't get the puck out. Europe keeps it in. Here's Tatar. Here's Kopitar. Chara stopped by Mrazek. Best chance of the period after a turnover by the Czechs. Team Europe pounced, couldn't finish it. Plays the puck in, Franz Nielsen. Down low is Draisaitl, Gaborik there as well, but he's closed in. He got himself open enough to get a shot. Too many bodies in the way. He'll pass off. Franz Nielsen, hard pass. Zuccarello to the front. What a save by Mrazek on Leon Draisaitl's tip. He got a toss in a hurry to the right side. Vanek sneaking into the right side. Hossa drives to the front of the net. Mrazek is down. The puck's underneath him. Hossa thinks the puck is in the net.
Penalty shot.
Penalty shot. Somebody grabbed onto the puck.
Here's a great look at it there. Good aggressive play by Mrazek. You cannot put it on top. Your left hand there of Kempney grabbed the puck.
Here's Andrzej Kopitar against Peter Mrazek.
But watch Mrazek. He gets that right pad down quickly and doesn't allow any room there for Kopitar to slide it in.
Yossi again. Fires the puck in, Mrazek missed it, Hansen can't get it, Benick at the empty net, Mrazek's down and he makes the save on Pierre-Edward Bellemare, who got the last chance. Kopitar won the draw, Chara's shot knocked down in front of the net, rebound, what a save by goaltender Peter Mrazek on Marian Hossa. Bellemare in front, centering pass, goaltender's lost his stick, Benick checked from behind, get the puck in front, Hansen can't get it, Chara scores! On a wild scramble, Mrazek lost his stick and got it back. Chara jumped into the left side and from a sharp angle makes it 1-0 Europe. Won the little battle for the puck behind the net. Golic to center. Voracek with a shot. He scores! Jake Voracek got a little room, snapped a shot. The Czechs have their first goal of the tournament. This game's tied 1-1. That hurt. Roman Pollock's down, trying to get back up on the 5-on-3. Centering pass. Hossa tipped one right on. Loose puck. Kopitar moves in. Yossi shoots. Great save by Mrazek. Just as the first penalty to Nyquist expired. A minute and four A 5-on-3, and the Europeans couldn't score. Zuccarello with his shot, he scores! After all those wonderful saves off the glove and in, and Europe has a 2-1 lead.
But look at the reaction. He twisted his glove in thinking that he had it. Instead, it went off the inside, and boy, after brilliant save by Mrazek, a weak one.
Here's Jacob Nakladl again. Alashimski starts to walk in, passes back. Savoca shoots a deflection wide. Hansel scores! With 11 seconds left in the power play, Karam off the end boards is buried by Martin Hansel.
And this one, another deflection off the skate. Halak down and a heads-up play by Hansel.
Off Halak. Breaking out is Zuccarello. Breakaway pass. Leon Dreisaitl scores! And the Europeans, the vagabonds from eight different countries, put together for this tournament, have done it again.
A back-and-forth affair goes the way of Europe as Leon Dreisaitl's overtime game-winning goal gives them a 3-2 victory over the Czechs. The 20-year-old had yet to record an overtime game-winner in his two NHL seasons. The Czech Republic fell short despite holding Europe 0-6 on the power play. Europe improves to 2-0. The Czechs fall to 0-1-1. There is no hyperbole in this statement. It was a must-win situation for Team USA, as a loss to the rival Canadians would eliminate them from the World Cup. John Tortorella's troops in search of their first World Cup goal against a Canadian team yet to give one up.
John Carlson to center. Here's Patrick Kane. Stepan takes over. Kane goes to the net. Parisi's in front. Loose puck. Price makes the save. They score. Ryan McDonough followed the play to the net, and USA is on the board first.
And watch McDonough. Knocks Vlasic into Price, gets the rebound himself.
What a start for the USA. They needed a goal. They have their first one of this tournament, the first goal they've scored since the quarterfinals of the Sochi Olympics. He left the puck for Thornton. Centering pass comes back to Vlasic. He waits, shoots, just missed the net. Duchesne scores! Karam off the end boards, and Matt Duchesne has tied the game 1-1.
And a heads-up play by number 9, finding that puck off the backboards. No hesitation on the backhand in the back of the net.
Set up by Vlasic from Montreal and Thornton from St. Thomas. It's a 1-1 tie. Quick after the puck, Corey Perry scores! 14 seconds after the Duchesne goal. There's some discussion about this, about whether it's going to count, but Corey Perry looks like he's put Canada in the lead. Pacioretty tried to clear the puck, he couldn't. Right in front, Matt Duchesne scores! Big turnover, big goal. Matt Duchesne's got a pair, it's 3-1 Canada.
Jim, Jonathan Quick has just got to be shaking his head. In game one, it was odd man rushes here. Another fluky play, a bouncing puck, but what a heads-up move by Duchesne.
Here's John Tavares with Bergeron. What a move! Tavares into some skates, he scores! Ryan McDonough is arguing this one as well, but it signaled a goal. John Tavares with a brilliant move heading to the net, 4-1 Canada. 1-on-3, got the puck through, Buffalo shot, another goal post. That's the second one in this period, the first on that power play. Here's Patrick Kane after the puck. Pacioretty with a shot off the post again. Well, I guess this game could be a lot different if even one of those.
That's the reality, isn't it? It's the old shoulda, coulda, woulda, it might have been, but it hasn't.
Rattles around in front off some bodies. Oshie got his stick up on Petrangelo. Now he's down on top of him from behind the net. Price made the save. He can't find the puck. It's in the net. And with 2:32 to go in the third period, it's a 4-2 game.
From the angle I saw, you saw the arm of Van Riemsdyk knock it. Had it gone in directly there, it wouldn't have counted, I don't think. But it's Joe Thornton who puts it in himself.
Carlson with a shot that's blocked. Another pass to Kane. Stopped by Carey Price with under 30 seconds to go.
Watch him dig in with his right skate. Get right close to the post, and Kane tried to sneak it underneath.
Dubinsky and Jack Johnson. Canada's 2-0, and the Americans will not advance to the playoffs of the World Cup.
Team USA is sent packing following a 4-2 loss to the rival Canadians on Tuesday night. A 1-0 lead for Team USA was quickly erased within a 14-second span in the opening period as goals by Matthew Shane and Corey Perry put the Canadians on top for good. Team Canada and Team Europe have now both advanced from the Group A pool.
The final game of the preliminary round for both Team Canada and Europe in the World Cup of Hockey. Both teams have already advanced to the semifinals this weekend, but the winner of this game locks up the top spot in Group A. Corey Crawford making his first career start in net for Canada in international competition. Yaroslav Halak once again in net for Team Europe. We go to the Air Canada Center.
Canadians won the draw. Bouwmeester's shot went off a body. Wraparound score! Sidney Crosby from behind the net. A wraparound goal that gives Canada a 1-0 lead.
A bit of a bad break, and Yaroslav Halak couldn't pick up where the puck was. And Sidney Crosby, to his credit, doing that so quickly from behind the line, gets it off the foot and in the back of the net.
Getting a great opportunity here to represent his country.
Claude Giroux, John Tavares, Steven Stamkos, he's robbed by Yaro Halak. Are you kidding me?
Look. Yeah, it is. If Tavares had been able to keep it under control, he might have made a harder pass, but look at, just got it over, and Halak read it perfectly and got the glove up.
Here comes Vlasic with a shot, an open net, and what a save. What a save by Yaro Halak on Brad Marchand. In the last minute of the first period, Canada 1-0. Duchesne, in fact, they score! A tip-in by Jonathan Toews. After all of those great saves, an open net tip-in for Jonathan Toews as the puck was thrown to the front of the net. 2-0 Canada.
What a backbreaker, too. It's just a little bit of pressure by Toews forces Halak to throw it out, and he throws it errantly.
Here's Andre Kopitar moving in. Air hop to the front of the net. Hosts pass, he scores! Threw it to the front of the net off Corey Crawford and in, and a determined effort to start the second period has Europe within one.
You see the reaction of Crawford. He just cheated off of his post for a split second, and that one went right underneath the right pad. I think Crawford can't believe that his pad wasn't down solid enough, and Hossa almost from the goal line makes this an interesting game.
Belmar got away from Petrangelo, the centering pass. And a stick of Josi broken. He's back without a stick on a 2-on-1. Toews shoots, he scores! Back-to-back goals for Canada from Jonathan Toews and poor Roman Josi. What do you do when this happens? 3-1 Canada. And Brent Burns is back. Stripped to the puck. Danik Hansen in front, quick shot off the post. Belmar's had a strong game. On a pass from Yannick Hansen, hit the post and it stayed out. Here's Vlasic with a shot. It's 4-on-4. There's a rebound. They score. Logan Couture bearing one up high on Halak at 4-on-4, and it's a 4-1 Canadian game.
I almost think Couture wanted Toews to be the one shooting that. Yeah. He ended up the one to get his hat trick, but instead now a 3-point night.
Is Jonathan Toews line that took over. He had 3 points. Corey Crawford keeps the line moving.
Canada wins Group A, defeating Team Europe in dominant fashion 4-1. Canada outshoots Europe 46-20. Sidney Crosby got the scoring started, and Jonathan Toews added 2 goals, giving him 3 overall. Toews also tallies an assist. Team Canada outscored their opponents 14-3 in 3 preliminary round games. Corey Crawford, making his first start for Team Canada in international competition, stops 19 of 20 shots. Europe, despite the loss, also advances as the second seed out of Group A.
Nothing more on the line between Team USA and the Czech Republic than the goal of avoiding a winless stay at the World Cup of Hockey. Both clubs have already been eliminated as the round-robin portion of the event comes to a close.
McCullough. Hanzo, there's going to be a penalty here. It'll be against Buffalo, and he just took David Pastrnak and drilled it into the net. And a shot from the blue line on the delayed penalty call, and McCullough has scored.
To the right of your screen, here comes Big Buff there. There's the arm going up for the cross check. Pastrnak gets back in, and Bishop down on his knees, didn't even see that one go by.
Patrick Kane down to the side of the net, a relay out front. They're going to pass it all over the place again. Kane. Parisi, backdoor, Pavelski scores! That time all that pretty passing worked, and it's a 1-1 tie.
If Pat Kane decides that's open, you've got Oshie in the middle, and it just went through, and a good adjustment there by Pavelski. use this experience to get off to a good start.
Bishop is down and the puck is drilled into the back of the net. Big scrum in front. I think Milan McCulloch pushed that across the line.
Suter was the lone guy in front and he's trying to handle Hansel at first and then McCulloch behind him and it's right there on the doorstep. And yeah, he tried to get it away and he can't get the hook of his stick on to get it in the corner and that's a bad feeling.
He's now back checking. Here's Big Buck. Stops up right in front. Great goal. Justin Applicator from Dustin Bufflin. 2-2 tie.
Suter's jumping up to who? Bufflin, his partner on the outside. Quick stop up. The speed of Bufflin backs Pollock out. Can't get a stick to stick. And it's in the back of the net.
Niskanen checked along the boards by Voracek. Jolie. Voracek trying to protect the puck. They score. Sharp angled shot for Andre Schuster.
He wasn't even thinking goal here. He's just collapsing down, and somehow that goes in. Look at his reaction.
Oh, okay. I'll take it. Alashansky breaks out to center. There's Roman Pollock again going to the net. Great pass. Great goal. Milan McCulloch from Hamsky.
And the defense just gets sucked in a little bit. John Carlson stayed in long, and that's a perfectly placed shot up and over the glove of Ben Bishop.
Gone to the bench here and he's in a little bit of discomfort. Yeah, he doesn't look like he's okay.
No, that might be his last one, I would say there, Jim.
Pull yourself off a power play. There's a chance for the Americans and they've scored shorthanded to make this a 4-3 game.
Hemsky's making a change here. Davinsky sees that they've got some time. The D are back way, way off. And Schuster doesn't really have an active stick. You've got Voracek, a forward on the other side who's trying to stop that middle rush. And as McDonough goes to the net, Voracek sticks in there too. Is it another own goal?
Or? Big crowd in front. Penalty's over. Kane across ice. Bufflin's one-timer was a weak one. Back to the front of the net. Pavelski. Suter fires a shot. Off a body, off the glass. It stayed in. And that's it.
The Czech Republic earns a 4-3 win, leaving Team USA winless in the 2016 World Cup. Outscored in three games by a margin of 11-5. Finland was the only other winless team in the tournament round. The Czechs close out their stay with a mark of 1-1-1. Team USA held double-digit advantages in both shots on goal and hits, but were unable to find the win column. Peter Mrazek made 36 saves for the Czech Republic.
The World Cup of Hockey preliminary round, Sweden taking on Russia in Toronto. Jacob Markstrom in net for Sweden in the round-robin format. Sergei Bobrovsky in goal for Team Russia. We head to Air Canada Centre for the action.
The screen set up, it's Kuhlman in front of the net. Very deliberately Malkin. Return pass, cross ice, Panarin. Orlov fires, Markstrom the save, the rebound. Malkin was trying to set up Panarin and missed it. Edmunds out front. Eriksson's already gone off. And the Sedin stay, a wraparound attempt by Henrik. Can't get the puck to the net, but it drifted through the blue.
That line is playing off each other, and you always have to have your head on swivel. Markov just goes to play the puck up, his stick disintegrates, and there's Bobrovsky bailing him out.
Against a different line, it's Malkins. Tarasenko there, Kuhlman in front, got one shot, trying to get the backhander away. And a malfunction by the Swedes defensively there, and Markstrom covers up.
When they're effective, they have those long shifts where the cycle game really gets the defense out of sorts.
Straight up the middle, Hornqvist is stopped by Bobrovsky. Russians got caught on the long change with a long shift by the Malkin line.
Very tentative, tight game, isn't it, defensively?
Backstrom wins the draw. Carlson on the other side, one-timer score! Gabe Landeskog!
Carlson with no hesitation, watch the execution here. One stride, Hornqvist is the key though. Watch the head of Bobrovsky try to peek around. A perfectly placed slap shot one-timer through a double screen and off the post and in. He can't execute much better than that.
Ekko gets to the puck and try to shove at this point. Silverberg goes after Markov. Swedes are on a change. Henrik Sedin stepped off the bench, held the puck in. Carl Hagman in front, they score! Victor Hedman jumped in off the blue line. The Swedes on a change, making it a 2-0 game.
You easily could have called too many men on the ice for the Swedes here. And Coleman and Carlson were not off the ice yet. And a good play, jumping on and getting involved. And it's Hedman who jumps right into the play. Stick on the ice. Traffic in front of Bobrovsky again, and he can't get a piece of it.
Just leads in his ship, so he's on his own. Malkin came up with him off the bench. Ovechkin shoots, deflection. Markstrom made the save. Here's Kucherov. Panarin tried to feed the puck back. Malkin followed with a shot. Nice save by Markstrom, and the rebound was knocked into the corner by Panarin. Tarasenko into the middle. Datsyuk, Malkin. No shot yet. Remember, they need two. They're trying to set up Ovechkin. That was tipped by Soderberg on the way. Now he shoots and scores!
Looked up, didn't see anyone to give the puck to, and just threw it towards the net. Look at the reaction of Markstrom. He doesn't track this one well at all. Goes right through, dips a little bit.
Datsyuk won the draw. Markov, Tarasenko stopped by Markstrom. Rebound, they score! This will be way above. Ovechkin put the puck in, but it's ruled right away. He directed it into the net without his stick.
Ovechkin right next to O'Rourke saying, no, no, hit my stick. Well, he thinks that he tapped it in after. There's no question that his left hand knocked it towards the net. I don't think he got a piece of it.
If he did, it's just a touch, barely a touch.
Remember, the call on the ice was batted in, so it has to be conclusive.
Is there a definitive look that overturns the call on the ice?
Upon review of the play, the call on the ice stands. The glove.
And Alex is dabbing.
Sweden hangs on for the 2-1 win over Russia. Gabriel Landeskog scores on the power play, and Victor Hedman's goal ends up being the game winner. Jacob Markstrom with 27 saves in net, while Alex Ovechkin made an interesting lead with a goal and nearly had another. Up next, Sweden takes on Team Finland Tuesday, while Russia faces Team North America on Monday. The World Cup of Hockey preliminary round. The North American team, comprised of Canadian and American players, 23 years old or younger, going up against Team Finland. Matt Murray in net for the North American squad, while Pekka Rinne gets the start for Finland. We go to the Air Canada Centre in Toronto for the action.
McDavid's the puck carrier. Matthews slipped by Ristolainen and heads for the net, takes the shot, and he's down, they score!
Right there, sliding by the defenseman, creates the chance. It's there for a split second, and credit Jack Eichel, right on the doorstep, and it's Eichel who gets his stick on it first and puts it through.
Jonathan Drouin drops the puck off, it's thrown at the net, and he's down, it's on the line. Didn't get across, Billy Poka just saved a goal. The puck was behind Rene, and number 22 Poka was right there to poke the puck away. Almost 2-0, and they will do a check just in case with hockey operations.
What a heads-up play. Puck's rolling, looks like it's going to have enough to just go through, but Polka gets there first and somehow able to clear it, not off the skate and in, but off the skate and out.
Call confirmed. Matthews hooked the puck around. It's still loose. Played on the goal line, but it's not in the net. Now it is.
Now does Scheifele knock him in? Oh, this one might come back because it is the move of Scheifele that knocks the defender in, and it's off the skate.
There's interference on the goaltender, so there's no goal.
That's the right call. It's not a popular one here in the building, but I think there's no question it's the right call. Again, it's the hardest part for young defensemen is to have that confidence in your feet to be able to cover the gap.
Parayko kept the puck and they score! Tipped in front by Johnny Gaudreau.
Eric Pass trying to get it out. Oh, just a jump to his left, but look at the hand-eye and body coordination. At the blue line, no question, that's in. Parayko, just the quick wrister, floppy puck that gets deflected underneath the blocker of Pekka Rinne.
Hopkins goes to the front of the net. Rinne, there's a rebound! They score! Jonathan Drouin makes it 3-0 North America.
Nugent Hopkins chips it through, and Drouin had a hard time getting a hold of it. See off of both pads there, but he got just enough of it to get in, and everybody loves a goal, don't they?
Drouin across the ice, Parayko took a shot, it was blocked, he gets it back and fires, big rebound, McKinnon scores!
A It's McKinnon's heads-up play. Instead of going back, stops, gets to the net, just holds it long enough to get it past the glove of the goaltender.
Komarov to center. Chips it, turns Parayko, and then goes after him and takes him hard to the boards. Puck comes out, but they score! Filppula on some great work by Leo Komarov. And there'll be no shutout in this one. It's 4-1 for Team North America.
And Murray not able to track it. You can see right there, just chipped through, and that one finds a hole on the North American netline.
Trocheck just works the puck along the boards. So it's one last hit, and Eric Kalla, who didn't like that, and a horn sounds to end the game. Impressive performance.
The young North American squad takes out Finland 4-1 in an impressive display. 19-year-old Jack Eichel with the goal, and Johnny Gaudreau also finds the back of the net. North America dominated in every phase of the game, outshooting Finland 43-25. Matt Murray was excellent in net, stopping 24 of 25 shots. Up next, North America in action again on Monday against Russia, while Finland takes on Sweden on Tuesday.
The World Cup of Hockey continues at the Air Canada Centre in Toronto as Team North America and star Connor McDavid look to go 2-0 in the group stage and deal Team Russia a possible knockout blow after their loss to Team Sweden in the tournament opener. And Team North America would come out on the attack.
Up the boards. McDavid gets the puck. He's trying to get away. Gets himself loose. Matthews in front. He scores! Austin Matthews first. Big goal in his new hold of 1-0 North America.
But look at the play made along the boards. That's what Paul Maurice is saying about what the North American team does so well. The speed of Connor McDavid forces Pavel Datsyuk to stop skating so he didn't take a penalty, right? And then a determined play at the net, tic-tac-toe, and right on the tape to tape is Austin Matthews getting his first goal.
Look at the North Americans go. Here they are, 3-on-1. Larkin, Eichel, caught from behind. Larkin with a shot. Bobrovsky with a terrific save. A 3-on-1, and Marchenko is the one who got back and broke it up. Brandon Saad stumbled a bit. Markov got the puck back for the Russians. Anisimov with an aerial. Bounced on Jones. Telegin with a shot. Big save. Rebound. Namestnikov scores. Scratched in game one. Back for game two. Tie game 1-1.
And it goes right off of Jones. And a bit of bad luck for Murray there as Namestnikov on the rebound hits the goalpost. Comes right back and hits the right skate of Matt Murray. And he kicks it back into his own net.
Bouncing puck and a goal right off the draw. Nikita Kucherov and a bouncing puck whipped it into the net and the Russians have the lead.
Trouba tries to clear it out, goes off a stick, bouncing puck that Murray can't find. And just another perfect shot.
Regroup in their own zone. Nice move by Kuznetsov on McDavid. He's 1-on-3, he'll need some help. He takes a shot, he scores! Evgeny Kuznetsov talked the talk, and then he walked the walk. It's 3-1 Russia.
Watch him put the puck just to an area. As soon as Morgan Riley goes with his stick, he pops it past his stick, and this is one for Matt Murray that he's got to have.
Corner to Yamalik. He knew he had to be quick, and he moved the puck in a hurry. Pavel Datsyuk. Tarasenko protects, shoots, scores! Fourth straight goal for the Russians. And they're up 4-1, and I think we're going to have a goaltending change.
Yeah, there's another one that found a way through Matt Murray. So, wow, how quickly things can change. Look at the back off of the D, though. Parayko and Trouba back well into the top of the circles. A screen set in front. A quick turnaround. I've said Tarasenko's got a quick, hard shot. This one gets through Parayko, goes past Datsyuk, and finds its way under Murray, and that's the end of his night.
Option after the puck. Kuhlman couldn't get it. Pass into the middle of the ice. McKinnon with a backhander just missed it in. Into the front of the net. Nugent Hopkins with a chance. Morgan Riley with a chance. He scores! The game got end to end and wide open. The North Americans are right back in it on a Morgan Riley goal.
A turnover, a little bit of over pursuit by the Russians, and traffic in front of Bobrovsky. What a perfect delay there by Morgan Riley. Just slides it for a second, allows the lane to open up, and Bobrovsky upset with himself.
Goodrow spins away from Anisimov, keeps the puck. Riley, one-timer block. Parayko shoots, Bobrovsky to save. Rebound, Nugent Hopkins scores. The determined North American power play makes this a one-goal game. It's 4-3.
You got to attack the net. They get two chances at it. McKinnon keeps it alive, and Nugent Hopkins with not one but two chances on it. Watch number 29 as he gets a hold of this puck. McKinnon bumps it towards Nugent Hopkins. Bobrovsky with one great save and hand-eye coordination to knock that one out of midair.
6-on-4. Matthews working against Marchenko. McDavid gets the puck back to the blue line. Goster's bear. Morgan Riley moves in and shoots. Bobrovsky to save. Rebound. McDavid's on the puck. Can't get it by Bobrovsky. What chances? Here they are again. Off the post. Goster's bear nailed the post.
Sergei Bobrovsky has been all over it. A couple of saves, close moments, gets help from Marchenko there. Might have saved a goal as McDavid. A one-timer there by Gostisbehere goes off the right post. And
Gostisbehere was thinking icy, but he gets back, fires the puck, and the Russians hang on. Bobrovsky faced a barrage at the end.
4-3 is your final after the second period flurry from Team Russia. Sergei Bobrovsky makes 43 saves, including 18 in the final period. And despite going 0-4 on the power play, Team Russia pull even with Team North America in the Group B standings at 1-1.
Group B action on Tuesday with Sweden battling Finland. An ailing Henrik Lundqvist missed the Swedes' 2-1 victory over Russia Sunday, but was on the ice for this one. The King looking to stymie a Finland squad, hoping to avoid an 0-2 start.
There's a shoot-in. Teuvo Teräväinen makes his first appearance. There's a shot from the point, there's a shot from the boards, and Teräväinen just missed on the rebound.
Here's the play along the wall. Granlund seeks an opportunity, threads one through, and gets a rebound that somehow Henrik Lundqvist, though, he made it with his stick there.
And, Jim, I thought against North America, this young D had trouble with their gap.
He had some trouble right there, too. Landeskog with a backhander, and Tuukka Rask makes the save as Gabe Landeskog got in behind that youthful defense. Won the faceoff. The puck is cleared by Ristolainen. A race for it. Gabe Landeskog got to it first. On his backhand, big rebound. And Ristolainen saved the day. Backlund just couldn't get to that loose puck on the rebound. Sebastian Aho out there. Patrick Laine, they're starting a change. And Barkov as well. Here's Laine, takes the shot. Lundqvist got a piece of that. Nice rush by Patrick Laine. Has some support though. Nick Backstrom with a shot off the post. Larson took him out of the play in front. Leo Komarov with a shot. Quick play by Laterra to Komarov. Caught Henrik before he could make the backhand pass. Daniel, Henrik, Stralman jumped in front. He scores! What a great read for defenseman Anton Stralman to jump in and finish what the Sedins started. And the Swedes have the first goal of the game. Joki Paka holds the puck and Leo Komarov into the slot. Valfilkina shoots. Great save by Lundqvist. And Carl Soderberg has the rebound that bounced to him. Deflected into the corner. Philip Forsberg out front. Backstrom is stopped by Rask. There was the great opportunity to get the 2-0 lead. Nick Backstrom stopped by Tuukka Rask. Komarov barged in the inboards against Hjalmarsson, who went down. And so the Finns get the puck back. Laine, one-timer. Great save by Lundqvist. That's the play they wanted.
And he's able to read the pass. He's got lots of time, and he gets across.
Here's Olli Määttä. Has some traffic at the net. Koivu's in front. Centering pass. Great save. Rebound. Granlund can't bury it. Koivu with a chance. And the puck was deflected over top of the net. At 4-on-4, the Finns have come so close to tying this up. Comes on the whistle. Here's Daniel Sedin feeding the puck in front. Didn't get to Louis Eriksson. Henrik Sedin. Eriksson in front, stopped by Rask. There's another big save as the Swedes try to seal this one off. Graylin to Koivu. Great play by Hagman. He poked the puck to center. In comes Louis Erickson. Stopped by Tukarask. Batman just trying to hold the puck in. Under 10 to go. Louis Erickson with an open net. And he hits it.
Sweden picks up the 2-0 win behind a 36-save shutout from Henrik Lundqvist as he outduels Tuukka Rask, who stopped 27 of 28. The teams were remarkably even outside of the final score, with 18 blocks and 4 minor penalties apiece, each going 0-for-2 on the power play. Sweden next battles North America on Wednesday, while the Finns square off with Russia on Thursday. Sweden can advance with at least 1 point against North America, who have split their first 2 games. The Swedes have yielded just 1 goal in the tournament thus far, but they were knocked backwards within the first 2 minutes of this game by the high-octane North American offense.
Lined up in the neutral zone, but look at the speed of McDavid. Up the middle, he shoots! Lundqvist makes the save, and the young North Americans serve notice that their speed will be on display. Here's a hot shot from Riley. Matthews scores!
Here's the answer in 30 seconds of hockey. McDavid through the veteran defense of Strahlman and Hedman. What a play on his knees by Austin Matthews. Through the seam, stick on the ice, and no chance for Henrik Lundqvist.
Jordan Eberle in the pregame show talking about the speed. Here it is again. Johnny Hockey stopped by Henrik Lundqvist. And a penalty shot for Johnny Gaudreau.
And that's 2 shifts, 2 penalties, one of them in the back of the net on the delay. And there's no question Carlson lost body. He gets the arm down, and Johnny Gaudreau wanted desperately. He pointed to center ice. So did Kelly Subban as he looks right there on the helmet pin.
Here he is, Johnny Gaudreau of the Calgary Flames against Henrik Lundqvist with a penalty shot. Missed the net. Back to the blue line. Shane Gost is there. Slap pass. Backhand shot. Score! Vinny Trocheck.
It's puck battles. It's puck control. There's 2 North Americans battling 4 Swedes. They come out with the puck. What a deceptive play by Shane Gost to spare.
Backstrom is there to Philip Forsberg. Hornqvist at center interfered with Seth Jones and knocked him down. Got away with it. And here comes Forsberg because of it. And he takes a shot and scores!
This goal starts at the offensive blue line there. It's Jones, as you mentioned, fall down. McKinnon thought he could keep the puck alive. A little over-pursuit there by Ryan Nugent-Hopkins, and that's a bad goal. That look at the reaction of Gibson. He knows that he just missed that one. Underneath the arm of Gibson, pretty close to almost getting it, was Ryan Murray with his stick, and that one frustrated the goaltender. What a big momentum swinger that is.
Carl Soderberg takes a shot that hit a skate in front of the net. Quick transition. Johnny Gaudreau with another breakaway. He scores! Beauty!
Lundqvist guesses to his left. That quick movement to Gaudreau's left. And an easy goal with that speed and quick movement.
Carlson the constant on the power play. Forsberg shot. In a body, a hard shot. They score! Just as the penalty expired, Nick Backstrom on a rebound to an open net. In front of the net, Oliver Ekman-Larsson. Henrik is screening, and he got a piece of that. Daniel with a backhander. Great save by Gibson as he kicked out that right leg.
John Gibson tracking this one. Sedin in front, the rebound once again. Eichel can't get it. 2 good saves, and then back to his post in desperation.
Swedes have excellent back checking from their forwards to allow those defensemen to stand up. Here's a chance in front, and a great save by Lundqvist.
This is what you got to keep doing if you're North America. Turn pucks over. McKinnon left all alone in front, and there's Lundqvist with maybe his best. Good track of the puck, but he was already down, but he had just enough to get that arm stacked above his pad and make the save.
Mattias Ekholm, Erik Karlsson, down low to this third line that's been grinding well through this tournament. Karlsson shot, score!
This block by Trocheck breaks his stick. At least he checks to see, but because he goes to the bench, they would have had a chance to get it out. That would have been his guy, and he could get there with the stick and maybe knock it out. Instead, they're a little bit delayed. They're a little bit tentative, and a perfectly placed deflection. The shot was great from the point of Carlson. He had his head up, and just a perfect deflection past the blocker of Gibson.
Puck disappeared in the corner. Nobody could find it. Shifley did, threw it in front of David. What a save by Henrik Lundqvist.
The drop pass, and it was a quick shot that Shifley was, Lundqvist trying to find it. You could see he pointed to the front of the net, and this is a bang, bang play that Henrik Lundqvist, who plays so deep in his net, just put that pad down and slid across, and Connor McDavid couldn't get it up high enough to get it over.
Nathan MacKinnon, Johnny Gaudreau, great move, shoots, Lundqvist fought that off, and here they come again, and center Henrik Sedin was all alone, McKinnon's all alone, he shoots, he scores!
Three quick movements from side to side, freezes Lundqvist, misses the poke check, and up and under the bar. What a set of hands by Nathan MacKinnon, baiting him to try to get the poke check, curl and drag, backhand off the bar and in. Perfectly placed.
North America earns a crucial 4-3 overtime win, but Sweden does pick up a point to officially clinch first place in Group B and a spot in the semifinals. North America will only advance if Russia falls to Finland Thursday, as Russia holds the head-to-head tiebreaker over North America. The overtime game winner was scored by Nathan MacKinnon, who has yet to record such a goal in his three NHL seasons.
Group B action in the World Cup of Hockey from Toronto. Russia taking on Finland. The Russians are 1-1 in the tournament, needing a win to clinch a spot in the semifinals. A win by the Finns would be their first of the tourney and would send Team North America into the semifinals along with Sweden from Group B. Russia would have to get it done without center Pavel Datsyuk.
Here's Tarasenko. Ovechkin. It's open. Feeds it across. Score! Tarasenko from Ovechkin, and the Russians are on the board.
Bad turnover, but what a heads-up play. Everybody in the building's thinking shot for Ovechkin. And Tarasenko with his stick down after he made the pass. Watch Tarasenko. Just calmly in position. Rask has to respect the shot of Ovechkin, and he buys in, and that's an easy tap-in.
Rene Kulka in a battle here with Telegin. He charged the puck loose. Dadnoff goes after it, and he's got Jokke Pekka sitting on it. Puck comes to Shipachev. Right in front. Telegin scores!
You can't fault Tuukka Rask for this one, but you can talk about his defense pairing. Jokke Pekka loses the battle down low. Komarov with an errant pass. Kulka can't find the puck, and a heads-up play by Telegin came in. Look at the patience here. The pass through the legs. Rask tries to mirror the puck across, but just doesn't have the reach. Couldn't get his stick out in time, and that's a heads-up play by the Russian forward.
Hidden by Orlov. Granlund got the puck. Toivo up front. Granlund stopped by Bobrovsky. The puck was loose. Teravainen couldn't get there before Orlov to declare it.
And here's the great chance down low as Granlund in the heart of it. Once again, a little no-look pass, and then goes to the front of the net, and there's Bobrovsky's best save. He just got a piece of that as Mikko Koivu tape to tape in tight. And Bobrovsky didn't get all of it, but got just enough.
Between Kulka and Jokke Pekka today on the first goal and the second goal. Here's a chance for the Finns. Bobrovsky's down, makes a save on Koivu.
He would have felt a whole lot better if he's able to corral this. Showed pretty good patience trying to get it around the pad of Bobrovsky, but Bobrovsky able to get out there quickly. Another quick turnover, but on the doorstep was Granlund as well. And Jim, that's been the story of the afternoon.
Ristolainen off the draw. Val Filppula is in front of the net. Linesman put in there, Johnny Murray, in a collision. He went down hard, and Ristolainen's down, and he's trying to get back. And there's Malkin with a shot. He scores!
And you can't blame Johnny Murray. He's trying to get out of the way, but he ends up inadvertently knocking the defenseman down. Now you've got a forward back on the defensive play, and this is one for Tuukka Rask. I said he couldn't afford to make a mistake. He got off his post, quick reaction, and Malkin makes him pay. No deflection there, just straight in past the Finnish goaltender.
That's it for this one. It's Canada, Russia again.
Russia wins it 3-0, advancing to Saturday's semifinals, where they'll face undefeated Canada. The shots on goal were close, with the Russians holding a slim 22-21 edge, but Sergei Bobrovsky turned back all 21 Finn shots for the shutout. Tarasenko's goal was his second of the tournament, while Telegin and Malkin each notched their first.
Team Canada, who went 3-0 in preliminary round play, taking on Russia, who finished 2-1. Carey Price in net for Canada, Sergei Bobrovsky between the posts for Team Russia.
And this will go down the ice, no icing on the play.
Only four Russians on the ice right now, and nobody's noticed.
A steal by Sidney Crosby, he shoots, he scores! Russians a man short, and didn't have a penalty, and Sidney Crosby makes them pay, 1-0 Canada.
An aggressive forecheck by Crosby, and count the numbers. There's only two Canadians in the offensive zone in Stamkos and Crosby, but they win the battle. What a heads-up play and a disastrous early mistake by the Russians. And maybe lack of shooting the puck from other angles already with Ovechkin there. Malkin took one from a different angle.
Here's Logan Couturier with a shot, and Bobrovsky had to make a great save. Canada's had two really good looks shorthanded. And a one the draw. Stamkos with a shot. What a save by Bobrovsky. That was a tremendous save by Bobrovsky on Steven Stamkos. Malkin knocked the puck away to the inboards. They gave it away. Jonathan Taves out front. Perry stopped by Bobrovsky. Terrific chance for Corey Perry. May have been surprised that the puck actually got to him. Nervous game for Canada, nervous game for Canadian fans. It's only 1-0. Here comes Kucherov. Hangs on and shoots. He scores! And the Russians have tied the Canadians 1-1.
Just a little adjustment there by Kucherov. You saw how he handled it for a split second, changed the angle. And then the quick release off the post and in to give this a 1-1 game.
Cycles back. Dadonov has got a man out front. It's Kuznetsov, the centering pass. Telegin shoots. He scores! And it's a 2-1 Russian lead.
And it's a one battle. Burns has a chance with Telegin. Can't get it once, can't get it twice. And then a little cycle down low that Telegin kicks it right over. And for a play that Carey Price thought for a split second was going to go wide, watch Kuznetsov right on the doorstep out of midair. There's the bird I mentioned before. And Tretiak with glee and surprise up in the box.
Crosby again, centering pass, tip. Bergeron can't get a shot. Crosby to Marchand, he scores! Minute and 12 seconds after the go-ahead goal for the Russians, Sidney Crosby engineers the tying marker.
Well, they're just shifts that you make a difference with your effort, and there's one that it's all about the captain. Makes the pass, sees the puck, wins the battle, gets it past Markov, and quick hands, no chance at all for Bobrovsky, and a wide-open net for Brad Marchand.
The middle, here's Bergeron to the front of the net. What a save! Brad Marchand going to the net, and Bobrovsky just robbed him. Bergeron to center, Crosby with some speed. Drop pass, here's Marchand, shoots, he scores! Brad Marchand has a pair from Sidney Crosby, 3-2 Canada.
Drew Doughty makes the play in his own zone right behind the line, a little shuttle pass, and it's the drive through the middle by Crosby. Just a perfectly placed shot underneath the glove. Quick wrister, no pass, no deception. Just mano on mano, the shooter beat the goaltender clean.
Jumping ahead is Panarin. He couldn't get a hold of the puck. Getzlaf's got it, a 3-on-2 to center. Tavares on the left wing, Stamkos to the net. Tavares hangs on, shoots, he scores!
Getzlaf wins the draw. Vlasic chips it up to him. It's speed through the middle. Tavares goes to the net. Getzlaf with a screen. And you saw the vision there of Bobrovsky. There was none. Great view from Wes McCauley. And look at the reaction of Bobrovsky. Never even saw it. Watched it as it goes up and over his glove.
Back come the Russians with 15 seconds to go. And the Russians slam one into the back of the net, and the clock continued to run even though the puck had been into the back of the net. So they'll have to sort this out, put a few seconds back on. It'll still be 5-2. They'll give them the goal. 5-3 game. Drop the puck. Everyone in red standing. Canada on home ice will play in the World Cup of Hockey best of three final against the winner of Sweden and Team Europe.
Team Canada wins it over Russia 5-3 and advances to the finals to play the winner of Sweden and Europe. Brad Marchand with two goals, and his NHL Bruins teammate Patrice Bergeron assisted on both. Also tallying assists on both Marchand goals was Sidney Crosby. The Conn Smythe Award winner this year also scored the first goal of the game. Team Canada continues to bombard opponents on offense as they outshoot Russia 47-34.
Team Europe and Team Sweden are facing off in a semi-final matchup to see who plays Team Canada in the World Cup of Hockey final. Yaroslav Halak is in net for Europe, and Henrik Lundqvist sets up between the pipes for Sweden.
In comes Thomas Tatar on the backhand. His shot is stopped by Henrik Lundqvist, and his forward progress takes him into the back of the net.
They surprised him with their speed. They surprised them with their transition game. And there, Henrik Lundqvist had to be sharp and stand his ground.
Stopped up, tried to put the puck deep. Eriksson the other way. Here's Gabe Landeskog to the net, and he's stopped by Halak.
Landeskog comes off with a purpose, thinks he has a room in, and Chara gets at least enough of him to slow him down and allow Halak to get a piece of that.
Anton Strålman to the net. There's a rebound. They score. Nick Backstrom on the doorstep, and Sweden has the game's first goal.
And I don't think they're going to bother with a challenge.
There's no way.
Maybe they are.
Watch the stick of Hornquist right there hit his pad. This one is going to be a good goal.
Call on the ice stands. We have a good goal. Team Europe loses their timeout.
Andre Kopitar to center. Gabrick falling in behind him. Now he heads for the net. Erhoff up on the play. Takes the pass. There's a chance. They score!
Back and forth three different times, and this is Erhoff just forcing it to the middle. I'm not sure, Jim, if Gabrick even ever saw that. He had his stick on the ice, just barely got it towards the net, and like a good curling rock, it found its way through the wickets.
So there are 10 countries left in the World Cup, and there might be two in the final, there might be nine. Quick shot there and a great chance. They score! Thomas Tatar!
A late reaction, unable to grab it, and then lost his balance in a heads-up play. Tatar kept his legs moving, tracked that puck. Lundqvist maybe thought he had it a little bit around, and just a little chip up and over the sprawling netminder.
Blocked by Zuccarello. Henrik Sedin off the boards. Carlson with a shot. He scores!
The Swedes kept rotating the puck from side to side, keeping it in at the point. And another great reminder, it's not always how hard a shot, just a little deflection there in front. Traffic in front of Halak, this is what he sees. He's got body out high, and I think that's Eriksson who got a piece of that one, Jim.
And the other way goes Thomas Tatar. Forsberg's trying to catch him, and does. Hittman's there as well. Kopitar kept the puck in. Zuccarello on front, Tatar scores! Thomas Tatar in overtime. Team Europe is going to the World Cup final.
Jim, the officials here are telling everybody to wait. It's the overtime, so it's reviewed automatically. Did go off his skate. This one might be coming back. Let's have another look at that if we can from above. Just such a split second play off of one. And it did go off his left toe and go in after.
On the ice stands, we have a good goal.
It is a good goal. Didn't take long to review that. And the celebration could pick up again because the Europeans had had a huge celebration in the corner. And now they have another one. And in overtime at 3:43, the Slovaks scored the goal that has given Team Europe an improbable trip to the World Cup final.
Thomas Tatar's second goal of the day lifts Team Europe in overtime to advance to the final against Canada. Marian Gabrick scores Europe's other goal, while Yaroslav Halak holds down the net with 37 saves. The World Cup of Hockey final starts Tuesday night at the Air Canada Centre.
The best of three World Cup of Hockey final commences at the Air Canada Centre between Team Europe and Team Canada. The natives are the heavy favourites versus an upstart squad from Europe, which was dealt a severe blow with the loss of Marian Gabrick as he suffered a foot injury in Sunday's semifinal win over Sweden.
right up the middle. This is Bergeron trying to get away from a forward. Niederreiter passes off. Marchand scores.
Two teammates have done this before a million times in practice and so often in games. And for Halak, a difficult first shot as it goes up and over the elbow. Perfectly played, though, off the rush.
Maybe not enough for a penalty, but not enough to get the goal.
Chara in his pocket pick. Ryan Getzlaf. Stamkos scores. Finally.
And an easy tap in for the game's second goal. Well executed.
What a load off the shoulders of Steven Stamkos. Finally, a big international goal in this tournament. 2-0 Canada. Here's Kopitar against Alex Pietrangelo. On comes Seidenberg with a shot in front. Tatar scores. He got a bounce in front of the net and had a wide open net. And Team Europe has made this a one-goal game.
Often you don't see Canada give the lineup that easily. Just a long pass and a heads-up play to get the puck to the net.
And they get the puck, and Doughty's now in deep as well. The puck comes to center. Here's a race. It's a defenseman. Sekera, shorthanded. Stopped by Carey Price.
And Carey Price not only makes the save, Jim, but keeps the play going. Wes McCauley all over top of it. No room in the five hole. Price didn't want to face off in his own zone, and the play continues on.
Short shifts early. Stamkos with a steal. Tavares with a shot. And Jaro Halak made his first nice save of the third period.
And Halak somehow read it perfectly to come across. But Tavares, under some pressure from Bellemare, couldn't get it up and over the European goaltender.
Here's Crosby. Bergeron heads for the front of the net. Bank shot by Crosby. Tried to put it in off the shoulder of Halak. Here he is again, right in front. Bergeron scores. Sidney Crosby, just when Canada needed him most, makes it a 3-1 game, setting up Patrice Bergeron for the goal.
And it's making plays in little spaces. He puts the puck off the net, keeps control of it, keeps his legs moving, and the backhand pass that he does as well as anybody in the National Hockey League.
Such a huge goal, because the Europeans have had a good third period after a great second. Here comes Thomas Bennett. What a play by Drew Doughty. He's had a couple of beauties in the third period, and that finishes it off. Thursday night, Team Canada can win the World Cup.
Team Canada remains undefeated in the 2016 World Cup of Hockey following a 3-1 victory. A pair of Boston Bruins bookended the scoring for the victors as Brad Marchand and Patrice Bergeron each found the back of the net. Carey Price was nearly flawless between the pipes, stopping 32 of 33 shots. Game 2 of the best of 3 series takes place Thursday night at 8 p.m. Eastern Time. Game 2 of what Team Europe hopes will become a 3-game World Cup of Hockey final versus Team Canada. Team Europe dropped Game 1 by a 3-1 final and face a must-win situation on Thursday night. Team Canada seeking global supremacy and a perfect 6-0 record.
Here's Franz Nielsen, hits the trailer. Sekera, Chara takes the shot, he scores! The defensemen both into the top of the circles. Chara from Sekera, 1-0 for Europe.
Back defensively, too much of a gap, and Bollmeister settles back. Doughty gets taken to the net by Ryder, and a great screen there. One of the few times we see Carey Price overplay. He slid a little too far to his right, and a heads up Chara. Doesn't even look at the puck. Not the hardest of shots, but it's the position of the shot that matters.
And out of center, there's a foot race. Toby Reeder, shorthanded, stopped by Price ever so calmly. And Franz Nielsen threw the puck back in the net.
They almost scored early on, then Toby Reeder gets another chance that Price is able to go on.
Just wide of the net. Doughty again. Gets left. Side of the net. Here's a chance for Tavares, and he hit the post. And a quick whistle. Stop play with 1 second left in the Hossa penalty. And John Tavares can't believe he just missed.
They finally find the seams down low. One effort there. And Roman Josi just down sitting in the crease. There's no way Halak's going to get back.
Out in front of the net, Tatar couldn't clear the puck. Doughty with a shot, off a body and wide. Here's Perry again. Great save by Jaro Halak on that wraparound attempt.
Watch Kopitar, the puck's there for a split second. He has a stick and he's able to clear it away.
Toby Kobe Reeder is there, so is Zuccarello. Puck stays in. Here's Marchand, side of the net. Crosby, great save by Halak on Sidney Crosby.
This is a determined effort off the boards. They collapse at the line. Marchand down to Crosby. Crosby thinks he can get it past a sprawling Halak.
Crosby moves in. Thornton goes to the net. Bergeron comes up late. Burns with a quick shot. Tip score!
This crowd's been waiting for something to get excited about. It's Joe Thornton in the face of Halak. He can't see it, but the high deflection comes right there by Bergeron. Look at the reaction of Halak. He's almost pushing off of Thornton because he can't see where the puck is in a heads-up play.
Plays it back, Bodker. Gets a return pass, walks in. Josi shoots, hit the post. Off the post and out.
Your best players have to be your best players. Roman Josi hasn't been able to put one past anyone yet. There's off the post. Look at the look of Carey Price.
Here's Kopitar from Josi. A wrist shot. Missed it in. Vodka. Back down to Thomas Vanek. Out front. Hossa shoots. Oh, what a save by Carey Price. Keeps it at 1-1 with 1:09 to go in the third.
Now Price with traffic in front pushing Vanek off. Nice little pass there, and look at how quickly he telegraphed.
Here's Jonathan Toews with Bollmeister. 2-on-2, shorthanded. Toews drives the defense back, passes off. He shoots, he scores! Brad Marchand!
And it's Jonathan Toews who just buys some time. He doesn't, knows that he's got a forward here in Vodka, just buys his time, opens up the middle, and a perfect shot. Coming off the bench, skating right into it, reached back for it, and a slingshot of emotion there.
Brad Marchand, his fifth goal of the tournament, shorthanded at 19-16. They'll win the draw, and it's over. 16 straight wins for this group. Canada wins the World Cup. And I guess we know the answer to the question. Who owns this game?
Team Canada comes back to stun Team Europe with the game-tying and game-winning goals in the final 2 minutes and 53 seconds of regulation, winning the inaugural World Cup of Hockey by a 2-1 final. Brad Marchand's game-winning goal was a shorthanded effort and his fourth overall tally of the tournament. All three of the game's goals were scored by Boston Bruins, as Marchand was joined by Patrice Bergeron and Zdeno Chara. With 10 points in 6 games, Sidney Crosby was named MVP of the World Cup of Hockey.